Anita T from FatPurseFitness.com. Many of you guys tuning in today probably are experiencing digestive symptoms, bloating, IBS, or even seemingly unrelated symptoms such as skin rashes, fatigue, headache, even allergy-like symptoms such as hives and things, and you probably don't know where they're coming from. So today we're going to discuss a little bit about that because I understand how frustrating it can be to go into a social situation, be not knowing what you're going to react to, wanting to go to restaurants and things, and not understanding exactly what type of foods are causing these sort of reactions. So today we're actually going to discuss a compound that you probably never even heard of, but it's in a whole bunch of your foods, healthy and unhealthy, and it actually causes 58% of people with IBS to react and produce symptoms or exacerbate their current symptoms. And it might even be behind all these other weird issues you're experiencing, such as skin issues and rashes and things like that. So yeah, let's talk about it. What is this mysterious compound I'm talking about? It's called histamine. So some of you guys probably have heard of histamine in relation to allergies. So think seasonal allergies. People with seasonal allergies tend to take antihistamines, and that's what kind of helps their allergies. And that's true. It's definitely something to do with allergic reactions and inflammatory responses. But what a lot of people don't actually realize is that histamine is in plenty of the foods that we eat. And there's not really any particular food group for you to understand exactly where it's coming from. It's not like a lactose intolerance where you just don't eat dairy. It's a little bit more complex than that, and it can be in anything from healthy foods to unhealthy foods. So it can be included in spinach and tomatoes or chocolate, for example. And that just definitely makes it really, really difficult to identify, which is pretty unfortunate because it actually leaves people suffering with this disorder since they can't identify any consistent pattern between what types of foods they're eating and the reactions that they're getting. However, if you're experiencing poor digestion, such as with IBS, or if you're experiencing bloating or something like that, this is probably going to indicate some sort of bacterial imbalance or some sort of digestive difficulty. And essentially what that can do is it can throw off the balance, and that can actually make your levels of histamine really skyrocket. And obviously that's not a good thing, because what can happen is it can create a lot of inflammation that can impact the bowel and create a lot more digestive symptoms, or it can impact any other system of the body because it's creating inflammatory symptoms. So that's how you can get hives and rashes and all these other things. So first off, what are some telltale signs of histamine intolerance? It's really, really difficult to understand it, and that's why it's so difficult to diagnose. And the reason for that is because it impacts so many of your body systems. So it can impact everything from your respiratory system to your digestive system to just anything really. And that can make it a little bit tricky because it can seem like you have an allergy or something else. So we're going to break that down a bit. And if you recall, what I discussed was that 58% of people with IBS actually experience reactions to histamine, and that's symptomatic reactions. So it does exacerbate some sort of symptoms in the body. So first off, your first big clue can be if you have any sort of digestive symptoms. If you have IBS, if you have bloating, if you have just general digestive symptoms or any digestive disorder, that can definitely be your first big clue that maybe you are going to react to histamines. So that's on the digestive end, and if you're ticking the box, then there's a whole bunch of other stuff that may or may not come along with digestive symptoms. It's not essential to have a digestive disorder, but it is a good giveaway. So some other symptoms that might be accompanying that digestive issues or on their own can really, like I said, affect all your body symptoms, systems. So it can be things like headaches, it can be things like fatigue, it can be, you know, your respiratory system's affected, so it can be like asthma or coughing or runny nose, things like that. Your skin gets affected as well, so it can be acne or itchy skin or redness or even hives, thinking that you're allergic to something and getting hives after eating something. These are all definitely associated with histamine intolerance. And interestingly enough, fibromyalgia has actually been associated with histamine intolerance as well. So there is some sort of connection there that's still being studied, and so that can actually be another giveaway that you may be reacting to histamines. Another big thing to narrow it down is I'd actually like to talk for a moment about the demographics of histamine intolerance. So 80% of people experiencing histamine intolerance are middle-aged, with the vast majority being women. So if you are a middle-aged woman with a digestive symptom or any of these other symptoms, fibromyalgia, if you have, you know, skin itchiness or redness, hives, things like that, but if, especially if you are a middle-aged woman with digestive symptoms, then considering a histamine intolerance is a really, really important thing. And so it's actually something that's not very difficult to get your symptoms under control. It can be done in as little as 1 week from your own home, absolutely for free. What you can do is you can actually cut out these high histamine foods, and that will help to balance the levels. Like I said, it's super easy. It's just a nutritional strategy that you can start right in your own home, which is really great, and it shows effects in as little as 1 to 2 weeks, according to studies, which is awesome. The funny part about it, though, is that these foods can seem really, really random. They can seem kind of all over the place, and that is one of the reasons, obviously, why it's taking you so long to identify exactly what you're reacting to. So to kind of curb this and make it a lot easier, what I've done is I've created a PDF with all of the foods that you can eat and all of the foods that you can't eat on a high histamine diet. And what you can do is you can actually download that onto your phone or print it out and put it on your fridge and use it as a little cheat sheet, because that is going to just be a whole lot easier than trying to memorize this really confusing list of foods that doesn't have any apparent pattern. So I would definitely suggest to go ahead and do that. Another great thing that you guys can do is actually keep a food symptom diary along with it, because that'll just help you identify the triggers really quickly. A food symptom diary is a lot more helpful than you would expect, actually. So along with doing the histamine diet, you can keep a food symptom diary. If there's something not on that list that you consume and you go, why did I react to this, or something like that, then you can check it out to see if it matches up with a high histamine food. So that'll be kind of a dead giveaway.